Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this awesome tutorial series on auto layout with tiny constraints in Swift 5. And we are getting to the end of this epic full course on tiny constraints. So without further ado, let's jump into today's episode. Okay. Now that you know how to handle constraints, tags, animations, and so on, it's time to talk about all of the tiny stuff that we kind of missed out on throughout this course. And let's just jump right into it. Let me just show you what I have changed. I have added a UI label and basically some examples where I can just simply talk about what we have just missed. And first of all, here you saw that under the tiny constraints, we have an extension for our view, set hugging and set compression resistance. Well, we are not going to dive too much deeper because it's kind of a blast. What you need to know is that some views in UIKit, like a UI button, a UI label, do have their intrinsic content size, and that is what hugging and compression resistant priorities are all about. Go ahead and take a look at the link that I have just added in here. You will see that in the resources too. So let me just show you by holding down command and clicking on it. And this is a great post that basically explains everything that you need to know about content hugging priority and content compression resistance priority. Go ahead and take a look at it. It's kind of a side talk here, but it is inside tiny constraints. So yeah, go ahead and take a look at what all of this means and how you could maybe use that. I didn't really had the opportunity to work with it. I didn't know how to use it, quite frankly. But yeah, you could use it and use your imagination. And maybe if you do, go ahead and comment out with the example down below in the comment section. Next up is tiny edge insets. And let me just comment this out, or rather, let me just write this out because I want to show you how tiny edge insets are a little bit more powerful that I have already shown you. So view one, so we are edging this to super view, excluding and so on. And again, if you are new to this video, go ahead and click the link down below with the playlist so you can know what all of this means, because I go through every step of tiny constraints. Okay, and I will exclude here the bottom, and you can see here that we have insets, and I always type in tiny edge insets and I get the top, left, bottom and the right. And now I want to show you something more interesting. And it is here, you will see that it's here, the Swift file, and it has uniform top, left, bottom, right, horizontal, and vertical. Okay, so let's just type in dot here, and you will see that we do have this initializer for top, left, bottom, right, but we do have a bottom, horizontal, left, right, top, and uniform, and vertical. So we still have zero too. So yeah, if you don't want to add this, you don't want to delete this property from the code, yeah, you could use zero to there. So what I'm going to use here, I just want to set this to the left and right and to the top. So I would just use uniform because all of the others are self-explanatory. Horizontal is for top and right, vertical, left, right. And here we have uniform, and that basically means that all of those four are the same. So let's add in here 12. Relation, that doesn't really matter for me, and I'm just using safe area. So let's add in there true. And of course, let's copy this out. Let's set this to the height of 500 and let's build and run. And as you can see, we have those 12 insets right in there. Okay, now that is all about tiny insets. It's pretty simple, but is very, very powerful. So let's just move on and take a look at a relation. Now, let me just comment this one out. So view two edges to our view one, excluding the right, and the inset is zero. As you can see, I have been using inset zero here. What this means is we are edging view two to the top left and the bottom of our view one. And now we want to edge this, set this width to 100, but there is something called a relation. And why am I talking about relation? Because if we just delete this and hit a dot here, you can see that we have equal or greater, equal or less. And I'm just choosing equal or greater. By default, this is set to equal because I want to build out a UI where inside this U1, we have, let's say, a name label and the button. So the name label should stretch according to the, let's say, the orientation or the size of its cell. But currently we are going to use orientation for this example. But the button, this view free, and let me just comment that out, should always have a width of 50. And that is just arbitrary. Let's say we want the button to have always 50. And we always want to pin the left side of the view 3 to the right side of view 2. So the button should always be pinned to the, let's say, name label with an offset of 12. So let me just omit this. I will just cut it out with Command X. And let's build and run, and we will see some constraining errors down here, or warnings rather. And there we go. I will just make this a little bit smaller, but you can see that indeed it did work out the way I intended to, but we have these errors, and yeah, AutoLayout just solved it for us and it guessed what we wanted to do. But that's not the way we want to do. Let me just have this to 50. We want to go back and have this relation equal or greater. So now we will span all the way up and it will have a minimum of 100. So at minimum, it will have 100, but it will span all the way to view 2 with an offset of 12. And let me just show you when I rotate this. And of course, as you can see, there isn't any errors in the log. So let me just rotate this and there we go. Simple, fine, super great. Okay, let me just make that back there. So that is the power of relation. And you can do this in another way. And that is inside a stack. And go ahead and make a refreshment on stack if you haven't already done so. And we are going to create a view 2 with a height of 100, view 3 with a height of 200. And let me just cut this out for now so we can see what we are talking about. And we are going to stack these two views inside our view one, and it will be vertically, and we will have a spacing of 10. And let me just make this 500 again. So we will have some errors, of course, because the total of these views is 300 plus 10, that's 310, and because the height is set of the view height, view one height is set to 500, we will have some constraints, and auto layout solves it like so. Well, basically, that is not what we want. We want to get rid of these errors. So one way I previously told you is to add a UI view, that is an empty UI view, that will solve this issue. So if I build and run now, then we will be able to have this as I believe it's 200. Let me just move this away. Yes, it is 200 and 100 for the green view. So yeah, that solved that. But yeah, what if we wanted to have this more? And just as a reminder, let me just delete comment out this. And if we remove this UI view, this will work perfectly. And that's the power of stack. So yeah, that's that. And now you can see that the blue view isn't expanding. So it's taking its height is taking the height of the views plus the spacings, of course. Now, what if we wanted to have this as more? So I will just paste that in and let's uncomment this because I want to have this as a height of 500, but I don't want to have all of those mistakes. So warnings in the log. So that is where relation equal or greater comes into place. And yeah, as you can see, nothing in the logs. Let me just make that pretty clear. And still the view free expands till it needs to. So till it is, I believe it's 390 pixels. Okay, that is great. That is great for views. But what if I have not a view, I have a label? Now, labels do have their intrinsic content size, so you don't have to even bother with having all of this set up. So let me just comment this out. Comment out the height. And let's see how to what we can do with only two lines of code. And this is our label. Let me just show you again. It has some text. And let me just comment out this number of lines because, yeah, we have just set this to text and, yeah, basic label. We have added our view too. And below that, we have added our label. And let's build and run. And I'm pretty sure that you will. You already know what happens. We have only one line here with a spacing of 10. Yeah, so that is why we need to enable multiple lines. And how we do that? We set label number of lines equals 0. So let's build and run again. And now you will see that this stack actually takes up the whole intrinsic size of the label. So that is how awesome this stack is. And let me just show you if I delete, let's say, half of it or maybe a little bit more or less. Let's see how this works and it will size itself according to the text. And yeah, so it is pretty awesome. And yeah, that's the power of stacks. So you don't even have to use this relation. So if it has an intrinsic content size, you can just use this with stacks right out of the box. Now, that is it for this tutorial. And that is it for teaching you how to use TinyConstraints in your iOS apps with Swift 5, of course. In the next video and the final video, I will try to recreate the Instagram profile page only with TinyConstraints. So if you did like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell because it makes a lot. You will get notifications of new videos as they do come out because if you subscribe, you may get your videos on your feed or you may not. It all depends on the YouTube algorithm. But if you do hit that bell, then you will get notified. Okay? And as usual, I will see you in the next one.